Hello friends, Barbara here. Adrenal fatigue, part two. Is this you? Aw, look at those tired little adrenals. Well, today I'm going to tell you how to eat if you have adrenal fatigue and if you're tired all the time and possibly approaching adrenal fatigue. And I have a questionnaire to find out if you have it or not, so you can write to me for that. But here's what you're going to do. You're going to eat within 1 hour of waking up. This is very important. Barbara insists you need high protein to keep your body from having to play catch up the rest of the day because that stresses the adrenal glands. Now, I want you to also avoid fruit and fruit juice in the morning. I don't want you to eat a lot of fruit because we find that people have exacerbated symptoms of adrenal fatigue when they start their day with fruit, especially if you've tried eating fruit in the morning and you feel shaky afterward, that's a sign. Now, cereal is not a good choice. Cereal is a carb that turns to sugar. You've heard me say in other videos that if you're going to eat cereal, throw away the cereal and eat the box because at least you'll be getting some fiber. No cereal for you, and that does include oatmeal unless you're going to put some protein powder in that oatmeal. And go easy on coffee in the morning. Drink tea, especially herbal teas, will be really good for you. Okay, that's breakfast. Now lunch. You're going to eat an early lunch. Yes, between 11 and 11:30 a.m. I want you eating your lunch because your body uses up the morning nourishment quickly and it needs the next installment to keep the metabolism going. So don't make them make your installment be 2 o'clock or 1:30. You're going to eat by 11:30 and I want you to have some meat or some fish, maybe on top of a nice salad. You can order any kind of salad and ask them to throw some chicken on it. A hamburger, protein style, where it's wrapped in the lettuce leaf is great. You're going to have a nice protein-rich lunch and veggies are fine. Now snacks. Yes, you're going to snack. And you're going to snack especially between 2 and 3 in the afternoon. Because if you snack then, it'll sustain you through the dip in cortisol that happens to you around 3 to 4 in the afternoon. And that's the worst time for many of you. You're just slogging through the day at that point. So what's a great snack? Mixed nuts, cheese, hard-boiled eggs, turkey slices, peanut butter. Grab a slice of leftover pizza. That's a great snack. I've got a lot of snack ideas in my book, Eat Yourself Slender. You'll run out of time to eat them all because I've really put an effort into showing you what good healthy snacks can do. So the early evening meal is the next rule. Now most people with adrenal fatigue feel better after their evening meal. So we're going to move it to a little bit earlier. I want you to eat your evening meal between 5 and 6 p.m. And you're going to have a high protein and lots of veggies. And by the way, this is not ad infinitum where you can never eat at 7:30 again, but this is going to be your ritual for a while we get that little adrenal function going again. You saw that picture. You need to help that little guy get back up on his feet. Now, the evening snack is going to be a high quality snack. You can email me or call me or read in the book of some good snacks. But you know what's a really good one? And this will surprise some of you. It's a baked potato. Because you can raise your serotonin levels when you eat the potato. And you can throw all kinds of interesting things on a baked potato. I like balsamic vinegar and cracked black pepper and some lemon salt. My husband likes to throw salsa on his. You could come up with your own. You could put spaghetti sauce on it. Or you could throw a meatball and chop it up on your potato. But just make your evening snack high quality. Because I want you to wake up in the morning with your cortisol levels higher than they are now, which is usually low if you have adrenal fatigue. So this food plan will help you have a steady supply of energy throughout the day. You'll probably even lose weight if that's your goal. Now you go, Barbara, can I have any sweets? Well, there's some delicious dark chocolate, go for it. You know, just have a cup of the herb tea and munch on your chocolate, and you're going to feel great and happy because chocolate raises serotonin. So remember to go light on those fruits, as I told you earlier. And fruits to avoid are the following. And the reason is they will raise potassium levels, and high potassium can exacerbate adrenal fatigue symptoms. So you're going to avoid, for now, this is not forever, but for now, bananas, raisins, dates and figs, oranges, grapefruit, and cherries. Now, if you're frowning, you can smile, because here's what you get to choose. Papaya, mango, plums, pears. Oh, I love crispy pears. Just cut them up and eat them like an apple. And by the way, apples are on this list, and kiwi, and grapes. Don't eat too many grapes, though, because they have a higher sugar content. And if you've been avoiding salt, you need to add a little salt in, because salt will benefit the adrenal glands. Now, you need sea salt or Celtic salt, because some of the signs of adrenal fatigue are caused by your body needing some salt. So there's 7 easy rules. Combine a healthy fat, protein, and carb with every meal. Avoid that fruit in the morning. You can eat it later. Eat lots of veggies, especially anything brightly colored. You just can eat those till the cows come home. Salt your food to a pleasant taste. No overdoing it. Just because Barbara said you could have salt, be careful. And eat mainly whole grain as your carbohydrates. And there's some really interesting whole grains out there right now. There's einkorn wheat, and there's tabbouleh, and what's the most popular one? I forget what it's called. The quinoa. Quinoa, did I pronounce it right? That's a great one. And rule number 6. If you don't want to eat a lot of meat, and you go, Barbara, I like more vegetarian style, then combine your grains with the legumes, which are beans, and or your legumes with seeds or nuts. That makes the legumes a complete protein. So there you go. And even if you think you are starting to have adrenal fatigue, start this little food plan. It's going to make you feel great. And call and write if you have more questions. And you know I'm on your side, I'm in your corner, and you know that I'm here for you. So you go forth and you nourish those adrenals.